Good morning everyone. Allow me to introduce myself. My name is Catherine. I'm the president of Gojek, part of GoTo Group. It is a pleasure for me to be here today among the technology enthusiasts who share the same passion for building Indonesia's digital sovereignty as envisioned by our president, Pak Prabowo Subianto. Today, we are so excited to introduce to you Sahabat AI. What is it? It is an open source LLM in Bahasa Indonesia, and not only that, also in its local dialect. It is co-initiated by the homegrown technology and telecommunication company, GoTo Group and Indosat. Most of us must have heard about LLM. It is large deep learning models that are pre-trained on the vast amount of data. Put it simply, it is a type of AI program that can recognize and generate text among other tasks. What is so special? You might ask, like, why are we doing this? Indonesia, as the fourth largest country in the world, we believe that there are so many cultural diversity that require needs, as Jensen mentioned, for localized LLM that truly reflect our cultural relevance. And what is so important here, Sahabat AI is an open source model. Why? Because we believe that we have to democratize AI access for everyone, for every Indonesian. Thank you. As an open ecosystem, Sahabat AI is very versatile. This can be used for public services, healthcare, education, media, research, so on and so forth. And because of that, today we are very, very pleased that Sahabat AI is supported, as you see earlier in the ceremony, not only by the regional research centers such as Singapore AI and Tech Mahindra, but also by many, many prominent universities as well as leading media companies. This is all very important because we believe to enrich Sahabat AI model, we need to work alongside with so many people in the ecosystem to build that optimal local context and cultural relevance. And of course, we are so proud that Sahabat AI is built with the support from NVIDIA. Starting today, this is the most important part, you can download Sahabat AI for free from our Hugging Face page. Where is the barcode? Here's the barcode. Please scan them, give them a try. Although we are in very early stage, I'm very, very proud on behalf of the team who are here, who built it, to announce that in the early stage, we have tested our early models, and actually the results show stronger performance in Bahasa Indonesia, Javanese, I'm from Jawa, Sundanese, that stronger than other open source model with the same parameter. Congratulations to the team. Lastly, as Sahabat mean close friend, brotherhood, we cannot accomplish this mission alone. We need everyone. Therefore, we would like to invite everyone here to participate from public, private sector, software developer, language practitioner, everyone. Please, let's work together, let's collaborate together in developing Sahabat AI ecosystem so it can become the most inclusive Indonesian language LLM that truly understand and serve the need of Indonesian people. Thank you very much. Now that we have talked about Sahabat AI, we in GoTo Group apply it. We create DIRA. So allow me to switch to Bahasa after this because we are talking about Indonesian LLM. DIRA is in Bahasa short for Dikte Suara. It's a voice assistant that now is being launching, so it's not fully there, in Gojek and GoPay app. The purpose of it is to make life simple. How to make the life, a day in a life of GoTo user more easier, more convenient. This is like, if you see the video, you'll understand my mom would love this. So allow me to share the video.
Dira, pesenin goret ke kantor ya. Dira, pesen GoFood yang kemarin dong. Dira, isiin pulsa Indosatku ya. Dira, cek pengeluaran aku dong.
Jadi itu videonya, boleh ya saya demo live langsung? This is very nerve-wracking because all the builder are here. I hope I do them justice. Saya mau live, coba ya. Siapa? Jadi pertama, kalau saya nanti ini dari sini mau pulang, mau ke kantor. Gimana sih order go-car? Dira order go-car ke kantor. There you go. With one click, we will be able to order GoCar. Satu lagi boleh ya. Sekarang di GoPay. Kebanyakan belanja nih, jadi harus ngecek pengeluaran. Dira, cek pengeluaran aku dong. There you go. Belanja makan, belanja macam-macam. So inilah Dira. Inilah yang kita kepengen ke depannya, bagaimana life of a go-to user, from morning until they go to bed at night, we help them. We make it simpler and easier. Di masa depan, kekuatan sahabat Dira juga akan mengerti bahasa daerah yang lain. Jawa, Sunda, Balinese, and many more will continue to develop this. Nah, kita sekarang sudah melihat bagaimana Dira memudahkan hidup kita dari beli pulsa, beli makanan, order transport. Namun kehebatan sahabat AI bukan sekedar kenyamanan untuk diri sendiri, tetapi juga untuk sesuatu yang lebih besar. Dengan bangga, saya ingin memperkenalkan the next speaker, Pak Bayu, yang akan memperkenalkan the next application of Sahabat AI.
Terima kasih, Catherine. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Selamat siang. Yang saya hormati semua hadirin yang hadir, khususnya Menteri Komunikasi dan Digital RI, tadi Bu Mutia sudah, kemudian Menteri BUMN, Pak Erik, terima kasih sudah hadir. I would like also to greet Founder and CEO of NVIDIA, Jensen Huang. Good to see you again, sir, in Indonesia. Welcome. And also Accenture Chair and CEO, Julie Sweet. Good to see you back in Indonesia. Bapak Ibu sekalian, baru saja kita dengar dari Catherine berbagai kisah inspiratif tentang penggunaan sahabat AI. Dalam keseharian, saya izin memperkenalkan diri. Saya Presiden Direktur and CEO Lintas Arta. Lintas Arta is IOH AI Factory. Saya Bayu Hanantasena mengajak rekan-rekan sekalian untuk menyimak lebih jauh mengenai Sahabat AI. Sahabat AI lebih dari sebuah platform. Kehadirannya menjembatani komunikasi dan mengurangi kesenjangan digital. Sahabat AI karya anak bangsa, upaya nyata kami untuk membangun kedaulatan AI di Indonesia. Sahabat AI merupakan LLM pertama dalam bahasa Indonesia dikembangkan oleh orang Indonesia di Indonesia untuk Indonesia. Tepuk tangan untuk Sahabat AI. Sahabat AI dapat mendukung pemerintah untuk memperkuat layanan publik dengan respon yang cepat dipersonalisasi, dan berbasis solusi. Mari kita lihat satu contoh aplikasi yang memberikan layanan publik. Fitur yang menarik lainnya adalah fitur
suara. Gimana prosedur atau cara melaporkan penipuan melalui panggilan telepon atau pesan SMS?
Jadi kalau mau nanya-nanya nggak usah repot lagi. Cepat, personalize, dan juga tergantung dari pertanyaan Bapak Ibu. Baik, jadi kembali lagi, Sahabat AI adalah platform berbasis data yang semakin memahami pengguna di berbagai sektor industri seiring dengan bertambahnya data yang dikumpulkan. Mari kita lihat aplikasinya di sektor kesehatan.
Halo, saya Rina, manajer perawatan kronis AI Anda. Apakah Anda punya waktu untuk berbicara sekarang?
Ya, mungkin dalam waktu 10-15 menit.
Saya ingin bertanya tentang obat-obatan yang sedang Anda konsumsi saat ini. Bisakah Anda memastikan apakah Anda masih mengonsumsi levothyroxine, riboflavin, dan digoxin?
Untuk saat ini, tidak mengkonsumsi obat tersebut.
Saya ingin mengingatkan Anda bahwa karena diet Anda yang direkomendasikan untuk kondisi jantung Anda, penting untuk memantau asupan sodium Anda. Apakah pusing yang Anda alami memburuk saat berdiri?
Kalau bangunnya tidak cepat-cepat sih oke-oke aja.
Kami akan meminta seorang perawat manusia untuk meninjau percakapan kita dan akan menelepon Anda kembali dalam waktu 4 jam untuk memantau kondisi Anda. Saya bisa memberikan Anda nomor telepon utama Rumah Sakit Memorial Hospital. Apakah Anda memiliki pertanyaan atau kekhawatiran lain yang belum kita bahas sejauh ini?
Ya, sepertinya sudah cukup. Terima kasih.
Sahabat AI, kemudahan dalam memenuhi setiap kebutuhan masyarakat Indonesia. Sahabat AI, simbol kemandirian dan kedaulatan teknologi kecerdasan buatan Indonesia. Mari kita semua membangun ekosistem AI nasional, menciptakan peluang global. Sahabat AI, LLM berbahasa Indonesia pertama di Indonesia, persembahan Indosat, GoTo, NVIDIA. Terima kasih.